Welcome to this tutorial on pre-roll logo animations. Done well, pre-roll logos can enhance your video content with consistency and add a clear brand identity that is easily replicated and makes it look very professional. In this lesson, we'll be covering the essential elements of what makes an effective pre-roll animation. This template is a generic logo sting. In the industry, a sting is the term used to describe a short, sharp flash of content. This particular template was brought online. There are lots of sites that offer this, such as Envato, Pond5, and RevoStock. Templates like this are designed for logos with transparent backgrounds. So a PNG file or a PSD are usually the best type of file to use. So let's open up the project in After Effects. The first thing is to import a high-res still logo into the project. Then locate the logo sequence within the project window. Double-click on it to reveal the timeline at the bottom. Then we need to literally drag and drop the logo into the composition window. Now let's resize the logo to suit the size of the composition. A nice little trick for this is to double-click on one of the transformation points, hold down Shift, and drag it down till you get to the desired size. This ensures that the aspect ratio of the image stays locked and you don't end up with a stretched or squashed image. Then we've got to go to the main composition that integrates the different layers and effects. Click at the beginning of the timeline and hit spacebar to see a real-time preview of the sequence. This is just to check that everything is working okay, as it should, and to check there's no missing media or effects that you haven't got in your program. The final stage in After Effects is to export the whole main composition. So click on the Composition tab and select Add to Render Queue. This will bring up the render queue in the timeline. In this timeline, we've got to then click on the Output option, which is here highlighted in yellow, and this will determine where to encode the file to. We then select a convenient folder and then hit the render button over to the right of the timeline. Once that clip has rendered from After Effects, we have to import that into Premiere Pro. So let's open up Premiere Pro. Locate the After Effects file that we've just exported and import that into the project window. So as it is, the motion of the pre-roll logo exported from After Effects is at one constant flow, which I think doesn't show much diversity or give it any sort of unique personality. So just the same as we did it in After Effects, drag and drop the clip onto the video timeline. Use the timeline cursor to scroll through the clip until the logo has nearly finished forming. Then from the tool selection bar, select the razor tool. If you simply press V on the keyboard, this is the shorthand function that will switch straight to the razor tool. Then we just cut the clip where the timeline cursor was left. The next step is to right click on the first part of the clip, select speed duration, and put that at 1000%. Finally, to join the two clips together, in the gap between them, right click there, select Ripple Delete, which will get rid of the gap and join the two clips together. Now let's add a finishing touch to that movement by adding an audio effect. Here's an audio clip that I think goes well with the movement of the pre-roll. Simply drag and drop that clip down to the audio track in the timeline. And then it's just a case of moving the clips back and forth in order to get them working together. So that's a brief overview of how to create a pre-roll logo using an After Effects logo sting and manipulating it in Premiere Pro to give it more of an identity. This tutorial only touches on the core procedures. This type of workflow can be done in several different ways and involve a lot more aspects of software features, which we'll be going into in future tutorials. One of the main points to take from this is how the use of audio can drastically enhance movement alongside the timing and pacing of the visual.